We applaud at this time. I'm gonna miss them if y'all leave out here like that. Let me thank you all so much. We really appreciate all of you being here. I just need to say one thing and I'm out of here. I want everybody to just look up for a minute. Let's look at the ceiling. We have in this building 10,000 square feet. A museum, African American museum. So before you leave, if you have 5 or 6 minutes, just walk through here. Where is my good friend Paul. He has gone to great expense. And in this building right there, there are all kinds of pictures and artifacts and all down that hallway, all the way down the stairs to where we were kings and queens before we were put on slave ships and brought to this place. The ceiling, this ceiling is one of 3 ceilings in this whole country, and churches are way likely heard of a slave ship turned upside down, and that's what that is. Methodist Church and the Church of the Nazarene, as a protest against the slave trade, built the ceilings in their churches like the hull of a slave ship turned upside down. The atmosphere is 1619. That's the year that the first slave ship landed in Jamestown, Virginia. The telephone number here is 241-1863, and 1863, of course, is the year that Abraham Lincoln signed the Emancipation Proclamation. The street out there is Lee Street, named for a Confederate general named Robert E. Lee. And when we learn about all of this, we put it in the museum. Because what you will see in this place, you won't, God bless you all in the school board, but you're not going to see it in the school system at all, because I see it here. And we want you to take a look at all of this. If you got time, it'll take about 5 or 6 minutes. We take kids through here all the time. I took a family through here tonight, so they can see and understand and feel what happened to our people for so many years in this country and before we came to this country. And I want to say one more thing and we'll go home. I went to the airport to catch a plane and I checked my bags and then they told me to get in line. So I got in line and then they said, give me your keys. And so I took out my keys and put them on the tray and they said, give me your change. I took out my change and put them on the tray. They said, take off your belt. I took off my belt, put them on the tray. They said, take off your shoes. I took off the shoes, put them on the tray. And then they said, take out your wallet. In my wallet, of course, everything that distinguishes me from everybody else in the world, I put that on the tray. Then the guy smiled and said, proceed. And I went through this metal detector, And when I got on the other side, he smiled and he gave me my wallet back, he gave me my shoes back, he gave me my belt back, he gave me my change back, and he gave me my keys back. And I smiled and I thanked him. Well, here's what happened. In 1964, the Supreme Court of this country, and through several other means, said that, you know what, we need to do something for black folks, and we're going to do something for black folks. We're going to integrate. So they said, okay, Floyd, give me your best teachers. So we gave you the best teachers. They said, give me everything that makes you who you are, your culture, your interests, your taste, and your value. Give it to us. He gave them that. Then they said, give us everything that distinguishes you from everybody else. Gave that to them. They said, now you can proceed to get on the integration plane. I said, well, wait a minute. What about our teachers? What about our interests, our culture, our history, everything that distinguishes us from everybody? Said, you can have it, man. Y'all get that on your way home. Come on. Sorry about that.